Okay, lesson number three. Lesson number three. So to recap, lesson one, we got up to our swan level. Lesson two, we introduced the shoulder bridge and side lying. And here we're going to run through those a little bit quicker, maybe with a bit of flow. And we have the one leg teaser to add in today. So let's make a start, as always, laying down on your backs. Just take a moment to settle yourself down onto the mat. We call this constructive rest position, okay? It's a really nice way to settle the spine and allow it to drop into the mat. Just feel your feet. Feel the weight of your sacrum, back ribs, long neck. Feel the weight of your head. Take a deep breath in. And out. Deep breath in. And out. One more. Breathe in. And breathe out. Allow the back to drop and widen. Okay. Just ensure you're in a neutral position for your pelvis. Hold your knees into your chest and give them a good squeeze in there. Keep the sacrum anchored. Leave the knees into the chest, bring the arms down by your sides. Alright, lift your arms up slightly higher than your hips. Curl your head, neck and shoulders up into your center. Bring your legs to tabletop. Start pumping the arms up and down. Breathing in, 2, 3, 4, 5, out. 2, 3, 4, 5, in. 2, 3, 4, 5, breathe out. Breathe in and out, 2, 3, 4, 5. In with the air and out, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now vigorous arm beats. You want to power those arms up. You want to imagine they're going through some sticky treacle right now. Knit the knees together. And as you blow that air out, deepen the abdominals. See if you can do this with an in through the nose and an out through the nose. Keep the curled up position. Remember, you can place your hand behind your head at any time to support and keep that curl up. Change over if you're having a go at that one. Keep the breath flowing. And we're going to do three more rounds. Still, bring the knees into the chest, reach the fingertips, and uncurl. Take the head down. Hands behind the back of the thighs, rock yourself up, the half roll back. Scooch ever so slightly back on your sit bones there. Bring the arms out front. We were working here. Let's bring the arms here. Breathe in. Breathe out, curl the tailbone and roll back. Now, can you get to your waistband? Breathe in, hold. Breathe out to come back up. Sit tall. Breathe in. Breathe out, power the arms up. Ground the feet. Curl the tailbone. Roll back, perhaps to the waistband. Breathe in, hold. Breathe out, lift yourself back up. We'll do two more. Breathe in. Breathe out, curl the tailbone. Roll back, sacrum. Waistband. Breathe in, relax your shoulders. Breathe out, deepest abdominals in and up. Last time, breathe in, breathe out, curl. Find your waistband, breathe in, hold. And breathe out, bring yourself back up. Let's take it back down nice and slowly for 8. Try not to use your hands if you can. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Rest the head. Bring the heels in a little bit closer towards your bottom. Make sure you're in a nice neutral position and we're ready for the one leg circle. So take the right leg up towards the ceiling, turn the kneecap to face the right shoulder, anchor the left big toe knuckle. Circle across, around and up. One, and two, and three. Keep the pelvis steady. Four, and five. Reverse. Breathe in, breathe out. One. Breathe in, breathe out. Two. Anchor the sacrum. Find the back ribs. Three. Long arms. Exhale. Four. And one more. Bring it up on five. Bend the knee. Place the foot down. Change sides. Left leg. Turn it out. Find the stability through this right side. Across. Around and up. Across. Around and up. Breathe in. Breathe out. Deepest abdominals. In and up. One more. And reverse. Out. Across and up. One. Out, across and up. Two. Breathe in, breathe out. Three. Exhale. Four. Exhale. Five and hold. Bend the knee, place the foot down. Hug your knees into your chest, hands behind the back of your thighs. Gently rock up for rolling like a ball. Scooch the bottom forwards. Pick up, we were here with the shins. See if you can work down towards the ankles a little bit, okay? Bring your heels in towards your sit bones. Lift your spine up towards your thigh bones and drop your head into your knees. Let's go. Roll back, rock up, balance. Roll back, rock up, balance. Three more. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. One more. Find the catch of the abdominals and lift. Hold and balance. Place the feet down. Scooch the bottom back and roll back into the mat. Seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Very nice. Single leg stretch, okay? So bring your both knees into the chest. Hands onto the right shin. Now I'm gonna work through the hand positioning here. Left hand to the top of the knee, right hand towards the lower shin. Curl up into your centers, reach your left leg out. Okay, so elbows wide, nice curled up, sacrum heavy, switch, exhale, stretch. So this time I've got my right hand on the knee, my left hand is guiding that lower leg in. Switch sides. So I want to bring the heel toward the sit bone, the knee towards the shoulder. Switch sides, exhale. Breathe in, breathe out. Breathe in, breathe out. Two more. Exhale. Last one. Hug your knees in, double leg stretch, no break. Inhale. Circle the arms, exhale. Inhale. Circle the arms, exhale. Just two more. Inhale. Circle the arms, exhale. One more. Inhale. Circle the arms, exhale. Take the head down. Scissors. Lengthen your legs to the ceiling. Hands behind the back of the right thigh. Root the sacrum down. Lower the left leg to the high diagonal. Pull the right leg one. Put it towards you deeper two. Switch the legs. Pull, pull. Pull, pull. Pull, pull. Pull, pull. Pull, pull. Pull, pull. Exhale. Exhale. One more. Pull. Bring your knees in, take your head down. We just have a quick look at that oblique twist again. So bring your feet down to the floor, connect the legs together tightly. Neutral position for your pelvis. One hand on top of the other, place at the base of the skull. Elbows are lifted in my peripheral vision. So curl up one. Curl up two. Highest position three. Maybe a little bit more four. Breathe in. Breathe out. Twist the upper body to the right. Inhale, center, and twist the upper body to the left. Inhale, center, and twist. Inhale, center, and twist. Inhale, center, and blow the air out. One more, and blow the air out. Come back to center, rest the chest, neck, and head. Hug the knees into the chest, hands behind. Rock and roll yourself up. And we'll take spine stretch. Bring your legs out in front of you. All 10 toes to the ceiling. Reach your arms. Breathe in. Breathe out. Nod the chin to chest. Nose to navel. Crown head drops down. Remember your plant pot. Breathe in. Reach to the sky. Exhaling. Draw your abdominals back. Draw your shoulders back. Stretch your fingertips forward. Inhale, come back up one more. Exhaling. Go for it. Let that head drop. Now I'm going to do something a little bit different here. Just bring your fingertips to the floor in between your legs. Okay, and keep pulling your abdominals back. Can you relax your shoulders? Just let your head go a little bit more. Activate your legs. Push through your heels. Can you go a little bit further? Your plant pot is rooted. The flower is droopy. And then slowly bring yourself back up with control. Stack your spine. Beautiful. Take your legs 2 inches wider than the mat for sore. Now, we were working with the arms here. Now we're going to take the arms out to the side. Okay? Really strong, powerful arms. Take an inhale, reach them up towards the ceiling. Let's just see if we can get right up onto those sit bones and then press the arms down long. Okay? Inhale, twist to the right. Exhale, reach across. 1, 2, 3. Inhale, lift. Exhale, center. Breathe in, twist to the left. Breathe out, reach. Reach, reach. No bouncing there. It's a reaching. Each one is further. Twist, lift. Reach 1, further 2, further 3. Come up. Exhale, center. Twist. Reach 1, further 2, further 3. Lift up and back to center. Bring the legs together. Roll the spine down. Can you do this with legs long? Relax your shoulders. Smoothly, reach out long, glue those legs together, and bring the arms up and over, circle around and down. Turn yourself around onto your tummies, swan. So, head onto hands, lengthen one leg, lengthen the other. Anchor your hip bones into the mat, come into your hover. Holding for 3, 2, 1. Take it back down on the mat. Anchor your hip bones, little bit of pubic bone, lift your abdominals. Up you come. Breathe naturally. And take it back down. One more. Hip bones, hover. 3, 2, 1, and take it back down. Hands underneath your shoulders, rock yourself back and stretch. Next exercise is shoulder bridge. So lay down onto your backs. Make sure your heels are quite close towards your bottom. You've rolled your shoulders open, you're pressing down through your arms, your feet are hip width apart, parallel. Curl the tailbone to the back of the knees, lift up into a nice high bridge. Chin away from chest, long necks, breathe in, find your feet. Exhaling, roll the spine back down. Breathe in, breathe out, come back up into bridge. Pause at the top. Now we're going to take something here. I'm going to fold. So really stand into your left leg. Really stand into it. And see if you can fold your right knee over your hip. And then bring it back down. Toe, ball, heel. Now stand into that right leg. Fold the left knee above the hip. Hold 3, 2, 1. Put it back down on the mat. Fold the right knee in. Holding for 3, 2, 1. Put it back down, toe, ball, heel. Fold the left knee. Hold 3, 2, 1. Take it back down, toe, ball, heel. One more each side. Holding. Put it back down. Left side, holding, and put it back down. Pause, and then lay easy down into the mat. Yeah, lovely. Roll over onto your side for side lying. Line the spine up with the back edge of your mat, bring the legs forwards to the front. Nice long line from your shoulder to your hip here. Okay, lift the top leg up, front and back. Kick one, kick two, reach to the back edge of your mat. Kick one, kick two, reach to the back edge of your mat. So I'm aiming to keep my body really steady. Imagine you've got a skewer through your hips here. You can't let the hips move. So if the hips were moving a little bit, just make the movement smaller. Doesn't have to be the fullest expression that you've got just yet. So you can just rein it in. As long as you can keep that upper body nice and stable, you're working from here, press back. One more. And press back. Bring the legs together. Lift up, two, three, press. Up, two, three, press. Remember, you can come down at any time. If that's too much on the shoulder, you can bring it down. Kick it up, one. Press it down, two, three. Kick it up, one. Press it down, two, three. Kick, press it down. Kick, press it down. Two more. Press it down. Last one. Softly point, circles. Five, four, three, two, one. Reverse. Five, four, three, two, one. Bring the legs together. Turn yourself around. No rest for the wicked here. Make sure that you align your spine up. Set up, legs forwards. Just check heels. Sometimes this happens. Okay, just check that the heels are really stacked. So the inner knee, so the hips, so the shoulders. Heads up. Top leg lifts. Bring it forwards, kick, kick, reach back. All at hip height. Forwards, kick, kick, reach back. Forwards, kick, kick, reach back. Forwards, kick, kick, reach back. For three, reach back. For two, reach back. Last one. Deepest abdominals in and up. Legs together. Lift up, two, three, press. Up, two, three, press. Up, two, three, press. Up, two, three, press. Kick it up and lower. Kick it up and lower. Kick it up and lower. From your center, deepest abs in. Kick it up, press it down. Two more. Press it down. Last one. Nice. Hover, small circles. Five, four, make sure you're breathing, natural breath. Good. Two, one, reverse. Five, four, three, two, one, and bring it back down. Lovely. Okay, one leg teaser. So we're gonna roll over onto the back. New exercise alert. So we add this one in, okay? Tricky little exercise, but here's the tip. Don't have your feet close to your bottom now. Walk them away so that when you look at me from the side, this would be a high mountain peak, this would be a low mountain peak, okay? So we want that. Arms pressed into the mat. Now what I'm going to ask you to do is extend your left leg, but keep your inner knees squeezed together. Yeah? If you've got a book here or a cushion, you might be squeezing it now. Lift the arms up slightly higher than your hips. Inhale to lift your head. And then exhale, you're going to arrive up into what is like what we call a teaser shape, one leg teaser. You're going to roll it back down, keep squeezing the legs together. As soon as your head arrives on the mat, you lift it back up again. Exhale, arrive back in that position. You've got one more to do on this side. So take it down. As soon as your head hits the floor, and up, 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 up. Roll it back down with control all the way into the mat. Bend the left knee. Relax. This doesn't have to be perfect. This doesn't have to be it. Your expression could be here. You might not actually be lifting. You might not get there, but you will keep practicing it. So let's do it on the right side, the right leg. Squeeze the inner knees together. Lift the arms up, power those arms up. Lift the head, inhale. Exhaling. I mean, this could be easier for you, I don't know. This could be an easy side. Good, that's number one. So we've got two more to do. Head hits down, head lifts up. Number two. Hold it. Keep lifting the chest, keep lifting the heart. And take it down. Squeeze those inner knees together. You've got one more. And lift. Don't worry if you're not up completely. Just have all the intention there. Good. And take it back down slowly with control. Don't switch anything off just yet until your head hits and your foot comes back down and you can relax. Very nice. Hug your knees into your chest. A little rock from side to side. We're just going to do one more exercise today, which is called swimming. So you're going to bring yourself down onto your tummies again and reach your arms out in front of you. Drop your head down, and like we did for the swan, just pick up a leg and the other one and make sure they're nice and long and stretched out. If you're a bit tight in your shoulders, just go a bit wider with your arms here, but they're stretched out in front of you. Now, anchor your hip bones into the floor. Just lift your head just up out of the water. Now I'm gonna pick up an arm and opposite leg. Okay? The leg is low and long and the arm is nice and high. And I push down on the opposite sides. And then I switch. Push down to lift up. 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 For four. For three. Keep that torso steady. Last one. Take everything back down on the mat. Take your hands underneath your thigh bones and bring your legs together. Lift your legs up and kick, 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 kick. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And relax. Bring your hands underneath your shoulders. Push yourself around yourself. Back over your knees. And take a moment to stretch. So lesson three, guys. Okay, so lesson three, we added in one leg teaser and a bit of swimming. So lesson four, we'll recap it all and we'll try and add on. Until lesson five, we've got our intro level completely complete. And don't forget, we're aiming for the 34 exercises. And at the moment, we're probably doing between, 12 and 15. By the end of this series of six classes, we should be more up to the 15. To 17 exercises, and then the intermediate program takes us through to the 25 exercises plus, and then obviously the advanced would be the full 34 exercises. So see you all next week. Enjoy, have a play, keep practicing, enjoy your Pilates.